Yes, quite a lot.
Did you ever see that film, The Hustler?
Yes.
Do you remember that opening? Hot road, two men in the car. Marvellous. The way they did the credits, do you remember? With the film stopping, then starting again. They do the same thing in the Uncle films. Do you ever see any of those Uncle films?
Yes.
The reason why I pick up hitchhikers is for the company. I like to hear what they have to say. Man can start out bumming rides. Before long, driving a car of his own. I've picked up a lot of people. They all tell you some kind of story. Doesn't matter whether it's true or not. Do you live in the city?
Most of my life I have.
I never worry about picking up hitchhikers, you know what I mean? I mean, some people think it's dangerous, you never know who it might be.
I've got to get out of this place. If it's the losing I am.
Look, I don't like the way the engine sounds. What I'd like to do is to pull off to the side and have a look at some of the plugs. There's a place up ahead where I can pull off quite easily. You can give me a hand. We're both going to town together. I guess that's all right, isn't it?
Yes, of course.
I've got some tools in the boot. I think it's important to have a good set of tools.
Do you want a cigarette?
I don't use them. Thanks. I've had this car for 4 years.
How old are you?
What did you say?
Why did you give up smoking?
There's a plug wrench down there. Would you get it for me? My daughter. I bet you didn't think I had a daughter. She's got this plan. She's only 11 now. She wants to travel all around the world. Can you imagine a little girl all around the world on her own? Well, I said to her, why travel? I mean, we've got everything here. Holiday, that's all right. You know, everyone needs a change, recharge the old batteries, all that. But you know what her plan is? She wants to live on the move, keep going, cover the whole world. She says she's going to start next year. Anyway, I said to her, how is a little girl like you going to travel without money? Oh, we have great times together, the two of us. We don't take it seriously, you know. But I mean, I say, who's going to pay? She's a funny little thing. See, I think what's really at the moment, she doesn't want to work. I think that's what it is. Anyway, what do you think of that plan, then?
I shall have to think about it.
That's it.
Look, I don't think I want to ride any further today. You go on and leave me here.
Oh. Yes, all right.
Thanks very much for the lift.
Let me soften you up with a bit of good news. Our request for two synaptic systems has been favorably received. Some of you place more reliance on this approach than I do. But I think we can all feel pleased that the general trend towards what used to be regarded as basic analysis is being continued at our level. But I would like to emphasize the need for revised speculation, which we discussed at some length last month. But let me get down to the main point. The reason why I have brought you all together is that over the next 10 days, we will have to start 5 committees, one of just under 300 people. I will direct that one myself, and I would like to start blocking out our plans. The big committee will be a fairly costly affair. All the invitees have contrary imaginations. There will be very few probes, and I'm hoping to hold this at the lodge. If it's free, then we can get going very quickly. The second committee, which I hope Phillips will take, will consist of 18. And Phillips and I have already discussed this at some length.
Our obligation to the community is a wholly negative one, not to do harm. Withdrawal is a morally defensible position. For society, in nurturing its creatures, necessarily owes it a great deal. Yet it is much to be doubted whether people themselves owe much to society. Basically, man has the inalienable right to withdraw from society if he so wishes. He has the right to argue that since society no longer provides the means of sustenance which he would like to see society provide, if this is no longer forthcoming, he has the right, therefore, to inform society that he no longer wishes to partake either of the rewards of society, nor necessarily contribute towards any of society's costs.
With regard to the motion, which has been with us for some time, I've only a few comments to make. And if I may be allowed to finish without any interruption, I'll take any points of information when I've completed my speech. Essentially, I'm talking about a very specific situation set in a much wider context. We all know what is at stake, and I would much appreciate it if we could, in fact, come straight to the point without the usual circumlocution which has tended to mar this debate in the past. Those who have spoken for the motion have done so with extreme lucidity, but none of their arguments has been relevant at all. Those were speaking against, to whom this comment also applies, have raised some very interesting arguments, all of which have been equally irrelevant. You all know what I want.
Excuse me, your coat is sticking out. Good morning.
Good morning.
The thing is, I'm sorry to take up your time, but something's come up and I shall just have to go away for a while.
Oh, that's impossible. We can't possibly let anybody go off. Waiting times are too long as they are now.
Well, I have this letter to go on a committee.
A committee?
I don't know what it's about. It doesn't say very much.
You can't tell from the letter what they have in mind. It's the usual way. You get a letter and you're off on a committee. It could be for a day or many weeks. Ever had one of these before?
No, I haven't. I've heard people talk about them from time to time. Do you know much about them?
Could be anything. I was on one, years ago. It consisted of 8 men. We were asked to decide which of 5 oranges we thought was the roundest. That's unusual, though. Mostly it's like a long weekend in the country. A sort of continuous house party. Great fun, really.
Seems strange how people just go along with it, though.
Oh, no. You've got the wrong idea. They don't bother people. You may have to fill out a form or so while they do the work. When you're off on a committee, you're part of it. There's no question of bothering people.
Well, what are they doing there?
Well, you might as well ask what a telephone man is doing going down a manhole. They keep the system going. Funny question. You'll enjoy yourself. I'll see that someone looks after your work. I guess some people come back a little changed. And that change can be a lot. Look, I saw an interesting film last night. I'd like to talk to you about it. Let me buy you a drink after work.
Yes, okay. Thanks very much.
Oh, would you all please go through to the main entrance hall and register?
Can we leave our suitcase here, please?
Yes, that's fine. You'll find your rooms in the building immediately behind this block.
Is there a swimming pool?
Yes, there is. We have quite a range of facilities here. Tennis and boating and so on. Oh, excuse me.
Yes.
If you would please be patient, we'll take care of everyone very quickly.
When we do
be sure to fill in one of these forms, and if we could have it back before lunch, if possible, or shortly afterwards.
Are you together?
Yes.
Room 37, please. That's in the block directly behind this building. Are you alone?
Yes.
Room number 8, please. It's in the block directly behind
yes,
this building.
You.
Could I please?
How long do you think this committee will take?
It's difficult to say until we've processed the forms. When the printouts come back from the city, I shall have a pretty good idea. Coming back to what we were discussing before, I think my position is consistent with the evidence of the past 400 years.
Haven't the past 400 years been rather exceptional?
Even so. I take it that you'll be leaving on your committee this evening.
Have any idea what this is all about?
I'm waiting for this evening. We could be here for a month, so far as I'm concerned.
You're so right.
Excuse me. Have your teeth been bothering you?
No. No, not especially.
Well, that's all right then.